Recording in progress.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
I can hear you nothing.
Recording in progress. It's recording. It's recording. It's recording. Recording. Oh, man.
I can't hear you nothing.
Om Namah Shivaya Gurave. Satchidanandamurtaye Nisprapanchaya Santaya Niralambaya Tejase Sankaram Sankaracharyam Esavam Vadarayanam Satravasa Kritam Vandi Bhagavanto Panaha Panaha Ismaragaratmeti मूर्ति वेद विभागिने विवाद व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणा मूर्तये नमः ओम शांति 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 हरि ओम। सो टुडे दिस टाइम गोइंग टू स्पीक some briefly the idea about Pasupat Tantra. Pasupat Tantra Shastra is the taught by Lord Shiva only. Pasupat, that you have been study also in Vigyanvara Tantra as well. And the Pasupat Tantra, one of the most advanced science of Tantra. And this Pasupat Tantra Shastra is not only a philosophy, but is a science one can do actually sadhana as well, with special mantras, special yantras. In Mahabharata, Arjuna did sadhana, and he prayed to Lord Shiva. So Arjuna get the Pasupat Shastra, a special. And nobody actually Pasupat Shastra, one of the advanced weapons. And it can actually destroy many things. So if I am clear that if anyone study Pasupatra Tantra Sadhana, one can actually free from inner fear, free from the inner fear, and also get the lot of miracle powers and whatever. So what I mean, all kind of Tantra Shastras is helping you how to awaken ourselves and be strong ourselves and enter into Shiva consciousness or the Vairab consciousness. But the Pasupatra Shastras, like you study Vigyanu Tantra, so likely I will check for you. So we can also go through that the Shastras, like the Sutras. So that also you can study in the future. But today I would like to have a kind of what kind of understandings, what you study, and what kind of inspirations you have out of these lectures. That is very important for me to know. And about Kriya Yoga, what I have been studying now, 20 years before I studied, I got the initiation in 2001, and exactly 20 years. Add certain things is very important for me also to know, and that only not only say it, it is a really secret, and that I would like to give the qualified devotees, the students of the Kriya Yogis. That is my wishes in future. understand when you practice kriya yoga a long time, sometimes why we have no profits. So why you have doubts? Because the lack of dedication to the master and gurus, lack of trust, lack of no Ishwara Pranidha, no self-surrender. So that also be clarified. What do you study in the Kriya Yoga? The main aim of the Kriya Yoga, so how to do Dhyana. As you study Kriya Yoga, one of the secret practice of the Tantra Sastras, Kriya Yoga, one of the important practice of Tantra, the main aim of the Tantra, Awakening Kundalini. Similarly, the aim of Kriya Yoga also, Awakening Kundalini. But Awakening Kundalini is not the ultimate goal of the Kriya Yoga. Ultimate goal. The ultimate goal of the Kriya Yoga to Dhyana, the meditations, that is the ultimate. And the all Kriyas you do, how to be free from the mind, how to free from the sixth kind, which is Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Madhya, Admasariya, this goes start Bikar. So six kind of places. We study five. We saw Vidya Asmita Ragadvisa Vinivesa. But I go to Tantra, what you study? Panchagni, I study Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha. They call Pancha, and the five desires to be free. Similarly, in Kriya Yoga, they see that as per the Babaji, Aladi Maharaj, they see that six Bikaras has to be out. Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Madhya, and Masarya. These are all under the terminologies. So, six kind of Bikara, the Dukkhas, to be free. So therefore, so Baba's Kriya Yoga see that, or the Lord Master, any kind of Kriya Yoga people do, I don't know. But as per so far concern, the Lord Master, in the Kriya Yoga traditions, they see that it's very important to meditate without I. Meditation has to happen naturally. So therefore, you have to come to stage. You have to come to stage of Kriya Yoga where meditation has to happen itself without any efforts. And that is the real Kriya Yoga. Like we study many kind of samadhi, that is very important. In this Kriya practice, they give importance of the Patanjali Yoga Sutras. They give importance of the, mainly they give importance tapa, soida, iswara, pranidhan. Three things are very important. And elaborately, they try to speak. No proper soida. Soida means not study all scriptures. No. Soida means where he can have actual self-study, self-inquiry. That is very important. And to know to yourself. Self means to yourself. And other means to the meditate. Meditate on your own self. Or meditate on your own self. That is called swadhyaya. But here, this is our meditation is about how to meditate itself without any efforts. So that is the aim of the Kriya Yoga here. But only doing Kriyas is not enough. As per this tradition, they say no. So Kriyas are only doing, that is not, does not lead to nowhere. Until unless we study in Viveka. Viveka is very important. Awakening of the discrete knowledge. Awakening within yourself. So that is very, very important. How to free from the mind. Free from the mind means free from the ego. Avidya, Asmita, Raga, Dvesa, Vinivesa. How to be free. Especially ego, avidya. That is very, very important. And tapasya. Tapasya means they say that how to practice kriyas. And sadhana means here how to meditate on yourself, to know yourself, not about reading all the scriptures. No. All is essential to know. But then, same. After that, Ishwara Pranidhan, self surrender. And dedications are very important. How to keep the techniques are pure form. secret and sacred. Secret means they say that one should not discuss this Kriya Yoga with others who is not qualified ones. Who is not qualified. You have to only discuss the people who initiated into Kriya Yoga. Once outside, academically also, they don't want these techniques. He may speak intellectually about Kriya Yoga, but practical things not. So, and in India, many people give the name of Babaji. What the eye work out, Babaji never appears in physical body. What you see in the Babaji photograph, an artist, they make the work out the picture. Actually, nobody knows Babaji physically. Nobody actually saw the Babaji physically. It's only inspirations. So therefore, Babaji means, actually nobody knows his name. Babaji in India, we give the sacred name, like Baba, like also people call me Babaji. So any holy person we call Babaji. So real name of Babaji not available, nowhere. Then nobody actually see the physical. Many people claim is out of a fake. It is out of fake. But Lord Mahesa, and he have kind of a vision, or maybe he met that time. Even Lord Mahesa don't know exactly how looks like the Babaji actually. So therefore, whatever see the picture of Babaji, the artist made it, is not real picture. Not real picture. So that you have to be very, very clear. And so that will be very clear today. Babaji came here like this, putting the Samvai Mudra, not actually. So these are the art, artist done, not the real pictures. So that you have to understand Atmanand. Because Babaji never appeared physically. And sometimes many people claim this is the Babaji, but all are fake. So because people want to marketing themselves, right? So therefore, and even if Babaji technique original, the Lord Master traditions, where they go? And for generations, many people actually mixed up. So actually original techniques, where real people know, very rare. So even in many schools, the teaching that is fine, but we have to understand, even if you get one technique of the Babaji, that is enough. You don't need all the techniques. And I'll tell you, certain techniques you can practice daytime, but meditation has to be done. Like you study Yoni Mudra, and that people call Jyoti Mudra, but Yoni Mudra has to perform in the evening, night time, because a lot of disturbance in daytime. It's different. So therefore, the Yoni Mudra has to perform in the night time. And meditations, already I guided you, that you have been studying the Khechari Mudras, and then you study Yoni Mudras, then you study Samvai Mudras as well, then you study Ajapa Japa, then you study already meditation awareness of the breath as well, and then Chakra Arohana as well. So, but there are certain techniques to know also more in future, but when you meet me physically. So I'll a little bit more guiding you in different level of the Kriya Yoga. Kriya Yoga is not one level. So that I'm going to teach you, and whatever I also experience, and whatever I got inspirations, and whatever I revise after 20 years, some new techniques. So that physically, when I meet person to person, so I'll check them. So what kind of skills they have, what kind of achievements they have, so I have to check them, then I'll teach the some kind of art, the new techniques at different levels. So that is clear to me. And I'm very glad that after 20 years got initiations, today also I got again blessings. It's kind of also initiations. They try to go to different chakras as per the initiations. Also today I got the special ceremonies as well. And we revise all the techniques. What I studied 20 years before, certain things to revise also today. All techniques to be revised. And whatever studies, and still you are in Kriya Yogas, because certain things we have to study as per the modern needs. Because we need physically to ready. And some techniques I add some techniques so that you can prepare your physical body, you know, receive and the Kriyas actually. But so therefore, and in future, so you can get time to time and when meeting, so physical touch, the initiation. So hope in future I'll conduct certain kind of Kriya initiation camps in Europe, very professionally. And I have all the details with me and different levels. I'll check them. So how and how many techniques they can get. So very interesting that for me. So after that, and the passage of the Tantra Shastras, what you study, began with Tantra. And in future, you are going to study Sri Vidyas. But very important that to learn one thing, in Kriya Yoga, they don't like to have any kind of miracles. No miracles. That is the origin of the Baba's Kriya. Say, we don't want any miracles. They don't like to have any Jyoti Darshans. No miracles, no fake. You have to go to understand yourself. That is very important. So they don't like to have any kind of Jyoti Darshans. Jyoti means lights or colors, anything. They don't like it. And they don't want to talk about it. Because if you do that, so then you are actually not studying the proper Kriya Yoga. You study fake. That is not the aim of the Kriya Yoga, to experience different lights and colors and all this. No. Is the aim of the Kriya Yoga to know yourself. To know yourself. That is very important. And become free. So Kriya Yoga is a technique that is going to help you how to understand yourself. The Atma Gyan. That is very important. That is the Vladimir study. So therefore they don't like talk about any miracles, nothing. No miracles. This is certain techniques on the Kriya Yoga people do in different schools. Oh, I'll show the lights and colors. So they don't like it at all. Because this is not the Babaji tradition they want to teach. No. They call it fake. So many fake gurus, they try to bring the lights and colors and whatever. And another way, there are different kind of sadhana. Tantra is different sadhana. When you study Sri Vidya, Sri Yantra sadhana is different vidya. They are nothing to do with the Kriya Yogas, right? So we have to understand. When you study asana, is different. And some different kind of pranayama when you study, they try to explain differently in Kriyas than the Hatha Yogas. So that is very important. Main aim of the when you study Kriya Yoga that is important is the Yoni Mudras. And then Mahamudra. That word you can study. They're the Kriyas. So therefore, and without Yoni Mudra is the final, because that leads to the Samadhi, that leads to the Dhyana. And then Ajapajapa also. But Ajapajapa, one can use Bij Mantra, but I emphasize that time to do soham according to different schools. But here they say that one has to be aware of the breath and with the Bij Mantra of the Om, not actually soham. So this is a little bit difference. Anyway, and when you and Kriya Yogi is there meeting, so I'll explain you some classes about Kriya Yoga as well. How to prepare Kriya Yoga and what to be practice Kriya Yoga and how ultimately you go to Dhyana. So ultimate Dhyana, that means in Kriya Yoga, going to Dhyana, it has to happen itself. And you should not make efforts to do any Dhyana. So that is the aim of the Kriya Yoga. Then you are witness. to experience Sat Chit Anand. To experience Sat Chit Anand. So here Anand means not actually experience pleasure. No. So here is experience of the self. So they see that bliss doesn't count as a pleasure. No. So that is different issues to speak. So that is very and important things to learn. But in Kriya Yoga, that is very important to understand how we experience this bliss. And here they say that union between Prakriti and Purusha. So therefore, in Kriya Yoga, they try to teach a little bit the second chapter of Bhagavad Gita as well. That I'll explain later. So many things, inspirations, the Vavaji Kriya Yogas. Vavaji Kriya Yoga. So I would like to ask you, today I'm not going to so much giving Pasupatra Sastra, Tantra Sastras, that we have to study once I get the proper scriptures. Like we study Vijnanavata Tantra, maybe you can do a little bit of homework, Atmanand, to find some scriptures, Pasupatra Tantra. But I don't think Pasupatra Tantra Sastra is available in the kind of common markets. Common markets. Anyway, I honestly telling you, I'm in the path of a lot of the research work for me in the tantras, a lot of research for myself. That you have to clear. And whatever I have the experience and my collections, my research, and always I would like to share with my special students, special devotees and disciples. That you have to be very clear. It is a long time travel. Spiritual journey is a long traveling. It's not one time. But what happened? We go to master, we go to guru, and we want everything here and now. This is not the journey path. This is not a journey path.
Swami Niranjanananda has written a book about Pasupata Yoga. Pasupata Tantra, but Pasupata Yoga by Swami Niranjanananda is written a book. Pocketbook for $11.
I can't hear you, Atmanand. My microphone not good or what?
Yeah. I'll try sending you the link.
Okay. Good. So now we can just speak normal today. What I'm speaking today, I give some ideas. So do you have any questions now?
Hello, Swamiji. I have no questions, but I have bought a book from Swami Sivananda. You know, that is a very helpful for me, a very helpful book for me. Wait, there. Tantra Yoga, Nada Yoga, and Kriya Yoga. And it's not a popular book, but it's a very, the subjects what we discussed are in that. So that makes it, for me, better to understand. So this book is for me very interesting. I just started to read it, so I don't know what is in it next, but it's very interesting. Did you hear me? Do you hear me, Atmananda?
Yes, I heard you.
Okay.
Thank you for the tip.
I will write it down.
Thank you.
Atmananda, today is not a very clear voice for me. I can't listen from you very clear. Okay, but you can listen me.
Yes,
but
yes,
I can't listen to you properly.
It's no problem. We hear you very well, but you can hear us, so.
Ah, good. Maybe my technology is something and not very good today. So anyway, so then it's very important to learn either from Shastras or Yoga Shastras. The four things are important here. I say, when it says Tada Drashtu Swarupe Avasthanam, so Tada Drashtu Swarupe Avasthanam means how to observe and how to accept as it is. So that is called Tada Drashtu Swarupa. One has to establish its own Swarupa, its own form. So that is going to help you how to meditate. How to meditate. But here they say that how to have overmaster the mind. It's a Chitta Abhriti Nirodha. How to overmaster the mind. And when no mind, that is called master of the mind. And no mind means that through the kriyas, and we have to experience no mind. Experience no mind. So therefore, the kriyas what you do, especially Yoni Mudra when you do, that Yoni Mudra itself is going to help you to experience no mind. Experience no mind. So Yoni Mudra, what to study. And other time, I'll give a little bit a different ideas about the technique of the Yoni Mudras. And Yoni Mudra, you can practice every day before sleep, maybe after 9 and 10 o'clock is the best time. Then after that, you can meditate. Maybe 20 minutes, 25 minutes is good to do. So kriyas is very important to practice every day. If I have no time, so at least you can go to Yoni Mudra and meditations. How to observe the breath with the Bis mantra, or simply sit down and observe and focus the Ajna chakras and observe the body after the Yoni Mudra. So Yoni Mudra when doing, what happening? So you're closing the 9 doors. But I'll add next time about Yoni Mudras. That need to particular mantra to chant mantra Om in the Yoni Mudras. So that I'm going to share with you and teaching you properly. Yoni Mudra is not only the breathing. That is another, it's a hot yoga process. But Kriya Yoga is differently taught, the Yoni Mudras. Sometimes in Yoni Mudra, one can have Jyoti Darshan. But Jyoti Darshan, not important in Kriya Yoga. It's important to have the no minds, have no miracles, has no form. It leads to the Nirakar. The aim of the Yoni Mudra leads to the Nirakar, no akar, no forms. Because when you have the form, that means you are not real Samadhi. So real the aim of the Kriya Yoga to lead to Nirakar, not Chamatkar, not miracles, not the lights and the colors to experience. So therefore, and you'll add in the Yoni Mudra mantra Om. So that I'm going to teaching you how to practice Om and during Yoni Mudras. So next Saturday, Sunday, I'll teach you some kind of the revised edition of the Kriya Yoga. When I'm a little bit out of my travelings. Atmana is tired today, huh? So I think today this much, if you have no any questions. do some chanting mantras. So late I chant Durga, 32 names. And I remember in my brain now. So late we do Mahamija mantra, Gayatri mantra, and 32 names of Mother Durga as per our schools for the Kali Yuga. And that's very powerful mantras. Very powerful. People do really sadhana. Om Trayambakam Yajamahi Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukam Yabandhanam Mritam Musyamamritam Om Trayambakam Yajamahi Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukam Yabandhanam Mritam Musyamamritam Om Trayambakam Yajamahi Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukam Yabandhanam Mritam Musyamamritam Om Bhargava Swaha Tassavitruvareñam Bhargo Devasya Nemahi Dhyayana Prachodayam Om Bhargava Swaha Tassavitruvareñam Bhargo Devasya Nemahi Dhyayana Prachodayam Om Bhargava Swaha Tassavitruvareñam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Nah Prachodayam. Now 32 names of the Mother Durga. Very important sadhana. It's called Shakti Sadhana. Akadu Tantra is called Shakti Sadhana. So my grandmaster, you see that when chanting 32 names of the Mother Durga, and you are doing real Shakti Sadhana. 32 knowledge, the wisdom, and you can have it. It's a special sadhana. And we do not in Navaratri, we do. And repeating these mantras and dedicate to the Mother Durga for Shakti Sadhana. Om Durga Durga Desamani Durga Padini Varini Durga Machidini Durga Sadhini Durga Nasini Durga Tukharini Durga Nihantri, Durga Mapaha, Durga Magyanada, Durga Daityaloka Dabanala, Durga Maloka, Durga Matma Swarupini, Durga Marga Prana, Durga Mavidya, Durga Mastrita, Durga Magyana Sansthana, Durga Madhyana Bhasini, Durga Moha, Durga Maga, Durga Martha Swarupini, Durga Ma Surasahantri, Durga Ma Ayodhanharini, Durga Mangi, Durga Mata, Durga Mya, Durga Meswari, Durga Bhima, Durga Bhama, Durga Bha, Durga Dharini, Om Shanti, 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 Om Gurubhyo Namaha. So, these are chantings. One has to do regular. Durga 32 names. Very powerful mantra for a Kali Yuga. And if you have intense doing this, and you can transcend your mind to higher channels. Higher channels. These 32 names are so powerful. Even is helping you to how to transcend the mind. Even is helping you how to awaken Kundalini as well. So these are mantras very powerful in Kali Yuga. Very powerful. But one has to do more and more. And sometimes you do 27 times. Then again, Om Durga Durga Tesamani, Durga Padi Nivarini, Durga Machedini, Durga Sadini, Durga Nasini, Durga Tutharini, Durga Nihantri, Durga Mapaha, Durga Magyanada, Durga Daityaloka Davanala, Durga Ma, Durga Maloka, Durga Matma Smarupini, Durga Marga Prada, Durga Mavidya, Durga Masripa, Durga Magyana Samsthana, Durga Madhyana Bhasini, Durga Moha, Durga Maga, Durga Martha Swarupini, Durga Masurasnahantri, Durga Mayudha Dharini, Durga Mangi, Durga Mata, Durga Mya, Durga Meswari, Durga Bhima, Durga Bhama, Durga Bha, Durga Dharini, Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Good to regular practice 27 times, but it's good to chanting after 10 p.m. or early morning 4 a.m. So it's more powerful. Like the Sandarlahari, the Sri Vidyas, Sri Yantra, and when to perform fast is very important to chanting all the verses, 108 verses. That I used to do also in Navaratri full. I used to do in a whole month. And I do silently also. Silently takes a 15 to 20 minutes. And it's very powerful. And when the external surroundings, when it calm, because it's giving more power, more strength. So Tantra Shastra is all about mantras. Mantras have the transcendental energy. And without mantras, there is no proper tantric practices. So mantras are very powerful. But mantras, one has to get initiation in the gurus. But as a sannyasin, you might no need all kind of mantra initiations, because already you have the profound guru initiation. Sannyas is kind of for the final initiations of the all knowledges as per the sannyas traditions. Even tantra, even yoga, the sannyas is one of the final initiations. But same time, it's good to get the advice and get the opinion from the gurus as well. So that is very, very important. Very, very important. So later, and pray also another mantra. Om Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Om Shanti 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 Hare Om. Once again, special prayer for one and all. And those who need our prayers for their own benefits, little peaceful for their life and happy life and coming out of all kind of miseries and difficulties. So late I'll chant today the mantra. The Chandi Mantra. Om Aim Reem Hleem Chamundavichaye Namaha. 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 Then, so all mantras, all prayers dedicated to Mother Durga. O Parasakti, please help us and bring the peace. Please help us and blessings us and bless us for our spiritual developments, for inner content. Let us be positive. Let us be devoted to surrender to your divinity. Once again, I'll pray Lord to Shiva today. Om Tadabrisa Vedmahi Mahadevaya Dhemahi Tanno Rudra Prachodayat. Om Tadabrisa Vedmahi Mahadevaya Dhemahi Tanno Rudra Prachodayat. Om Tadabrisa Vedmahi Mahadevaya Dhemahi Tanno Rudra Prachodayan. Then Sandarlahari, just I'll chant one mantra today and pray to the Parasakti. Dedication to Parasakti. Iswar Pranidhan. Om Trayanam Devanam Triguna Janitanam Apisive Bhavet Poja Poja Tava charanaya arya virachita tatha hi tatpado dahana mani petha sthanikate sita etme sasvam mukulita karota samukutam namaste namaste vibhavi samurte Namaste, Namaste, Chidananda Murte,
Namaste, namaste, tapo yoga gamya. Namaste, namaste, smriti jnana gamya. Namaste, namaste, vibhave samurtim. Namaste, namaste, chidananda murti. Om Gong Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om. So thanks to all of you. Today the special prayers. Today special prayer let dedicate to the Lord Shiva, all gurus, and to Parasakti, and Mother Shakti, Parasakti, Mother Durga, and Mother Kali. Om 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 Om. Om Sangaram Sangaracharyam Kesavam Vadarayanam Sutraha Sakratam Vande Bhagavanto Punaha Punaha Iswara Guru Ratmeti Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyamavadvyapta Dehaya Siddhachina Murtaye Namaha Siddhachina Murtaye Namaha Siddhachina Murtaye Namaha. Om Hari Om Tassat, Hari Om Tassat, Hari Om Tassat. Let's dedicate all our knowledge today to the Adi Guru Sankaracharya, to his lotus feet.